Happy Tuesday, Pace Eagles. I'm Joey Mitchell.
And I'm Ty Crafton.
Let's get this show started with Ms. Tapley and the pledges.
Good morning, Eagles. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and the Pace Pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. We at Pace pledge to treat everyone with fairness, kindness, and respect.
First up is Notes from the Nurse.
Hi everyone, my name is Brennan Wynot.
I'm Nurse Field.
With spring almost around the corner, there are a wide selection of energy drinks and sports drinks, though there's a lot of sugar in them. Nurse Fields, why should we worry about how much sugar we take every day?
That is a great question. So sugar is a big inflammation in the body. It is very hard on your heart, your stomach, your pancreas, your kidneys. It puts a lot of pressure on everything. It makes things not flow and swell up. And it's really best we avoid sugar intake as much as we can. And go for drinks and food that have the least amount of sugar in it.
So let's go through what is the least amount to the most amount. To start off with, here you go, we have a simple water bottle. How much sugar is in it?
Zero. This would probably be your best choice to go for in the hot summer, springtime. To hydrate with no sugar in it, no inflammation, go for that nice, cool water. Zero.
All right, and then on to the next one, we have, Red Bull.
Red Bull, kids go for it thinking they're going to get a lot of energy, like a cup of coffee or something. The problem with this is it's got a lot of sugar in it for just an 8-ounce can. You have 6 3/4 teaspoons. That's how much is in there. That's quite a bit.
It is quite a bit.
That would be one you would not go for.
Then going higher and higher. Oh, and this is one that the kiddos would always go for.
So Capri Sun, yes, we see it a lot in lunch boxes. It's got the juice in it, and it's got some water in it, but those companies like to make it tasty, and they add some sugar in it. This only 6-ounce Capri Sun bag has 4.2 teaspoons. So 4 teaspoons, a little over 4. That's a lot for that little
it
bag.
It is quite a lot. On to the next one, for the most famous known sports drink out there is Gatorade.
All right, Gatorade can be a good hydration, maybe if you get it in the zero sugar form or the reduced sugar form, because it does have some electrolytes in it and stuff. But the companies like to add that sugar in it. This has 9 teaspoons of sugar in it. When you can get just as much of that electrolyte with a zero Gatorade or your water, and that would be something to swap out your Gatorade with.
And on to a more of a soft drink, we have the infamous Coca-Cola.
Well, I know sodas are still popular, the Sprites and the Coca-Colas, but this has 16 teaspoons of sugar in it, in this 20 fluid ounce bottle. Look, that's a lot. Imagine eating all that. That is a lot of inflammation.
Quite a lot. And now on to our final one, and it is Mountain Dew.
Okay, Mountain Dew is actually illegal in some countries because of all the sugar in that 20 fluid ounce. This has a little over 19 teaspoons. That's how much you're consuming in that bottle. That is a lot. That is probably 2 donuts. That is a lot.
Oh,
that's not something I would grab to hydrate myself.
Now, that is all for today, Pace Eagles. We will see you next time.
Grab that water.
Bye.
Which famous actor served in World War II? Which president served in the United States Navy during World War II?
Today's quote is, "If they don't like you for being yourself, be yourself even more," by Taylor Swift.
That is a great quote. She's a really good singer.
She sure is. That's all for today. Have a terrific Tuesday.
See ya!
PNN.